Welcome to my channel MK Mediguide Lectures, learning with artworks like drawing and calligraphy. In today's lecture, we are going to study about the pathophysiology and symptoms of COVID-19. The outbreak of emerging severe acute respiratory syndrome coronavirus 2, SARS-CoV2 disease COVID-19 in China has been declared a pandemic by the World Health Organization, WHO. COVID-19 have accelerated scientists to understand this new virus and the pathophysiology of this disease to uncover possible treatment regimens and discover effective therapeutic agents and vaccines, as no specific therapeutics and vaccines are available for the disease control. The novel virus was initially named 2019 novel coronavirus, which was changed to severe acute respiratory syndrome coronavirus 2, for short SARS-CoV2, by International Committee on Taxonomy of Viruses, ICTV. Due to the genetic sequence of this virus showed more than 80% identity with SARS coronavirus. The disease caused by this virus was termed COVID-19, which stands for Coronavirus Disease 2019. It is suggested that this virus is of zoonotic origin because all human coronaviruses that have infected humans till now are of zoonotic origin, and bats are most likely the natural hosts for all presently known coronaviruses. It is investigated that coronaviruses found in bats cannot directly infect humans unless they undergo some mutations or recombination in an intermediate animal host. For example, intermediate animal host of SARS coronavirus is the civet before transmission to humans in 2002 and camel for MERS coronavirus in 2012. Regarding the intermediate animal host of SARS-CoV2, it has been considered that pangolin is the intermediate host for this virus because the genetic sequence identity between coronavirus found in pangolin and SARS-CoV2 is 99% identical. SARS coronavirus 2 is the largest known RNA virus with a round or an oval shape, and due to the presence of spike glycoproteins on the envelope, they show crown-like appearance under an electron microscope. That's why they are named corona, derived from coronum, a Latin term for crown, and possesses a nucleocapsid composed of positive sense single-stranded RNA and nucleocapsid proteins. The nucleocapsid is buried inside phospholipid bilayers and covered by spike proteins, and the membrane and envelope proteins are found among the spike proteins in the viral envelope. The coronaviruses are divided into four subfamilies: alpha coronaviruses, beta coronaviruses, gamma coronaviruses, and delta coronaviruses. Human coronavirus infections are caused by alpha and beta coronaviruses. SARS coronavirus and MERS coronavirus are members of beta coronaviruses, and due to close identity of novel coronavirus with SARS coronavirus, it is also being included in beta coronaviruses. Currently, COVID-19 patients are the main source of infection, and severe patients are considered to be more contagious than mild ones. Transmission from one to another individual occurs mainly with respiratory droplets in contact. In addition, transmission may also occur through fecal-oral route due to the presence of virus in feces of the infected person. Besides, the virus also found in urine of the infected person. Additionally, samples taken from patients recovered from COVID-19 continuously show a positive RT-PCR test, which has never been seen in the history of human infectious diseases. In other words, asymptomatically infected persons and patients in incubation or recovered from COVID-19 may put forward serious challenges for disease prevention and control. The infection starts when the virus starts its journey from nose, mouth, or eyes epithelial cells, making it to the alveoli of the lungs. The walls of the alveoli are made up of two types of epithelial cells, type 1 and type 2 alveolar cells, which are surrounded by blood capillaries. Type 1 cells are thin and the gas exchange occurs through it very easily. In type 2 cells, which produces surfactants, making the alveoli patent, mean, often, and expanded. Angiotensin-converting enzyme 2 is a membrane protein expressed in lung, heart, kidney, and intestine mainly. And importantly, 83% of ACE2 expressing cells are alveolar epithelial type 2 cells. That's why lungs are the main target of this virus. The virus binds to it through van der Waal forces by using its spikes. Its one subunit is used for attachment, mean binding with the receptor, and the membrane of the virus fuses with the host membrane through its two subunit. After fusion of viral in host cell membrane, the virus injects its genetic material to the cell, which acts as mRNA for translation of polyproteins 1A and 1B. Proteolytic cleavage of these polyproteins then produces a number of non-structural proteins, including RNA-dependent RNA polymerase, helicase, and non-structural proteins 3, 4, and 6. These non-structural proteins 3, 4, and 6 are thought to be responsible for the gaining of virus RNA replicase transcriptase complex through recruitment of endoplasmic reticulum membranes to form double membrane vesicles. RNA-dependent RNA polymerase and helicase localize to these vesicles and originate the production of subgenomic RNAs from which the structural and other accessory proteins like N, E, M, and S proteins are produced in the next phase of translation. Once synthesized, transmembrane structural proteins S, M, and E are inserted in the endoplasmic reticulum membrane and then transported to endoplasmic reticulum Golgi intermediate compartment, while the N proteins at this stage bind with the viral positive sense single-stranded RNA, which are derived from replication transcription phase, and form nucleocapsid. These nucleocapsids pack to these compartments and leave the cell by exocytosis as whichever SARS-CoV-2 ready to infect other cells. When type 2 alveolar cells are infected, they release inflammatory signals which recruit macrophages. Stimulated macrophages release more cytokines like tumor necrosis factor alpha, interleukin 1, 2, and 8, as well as other chemokines. These chemical signals cause vasodilation and increase capillary permeability. The most common symptoms at onset of COVID-19 illness are fever, cough, and fatigue, while other symptoms include sputum production, headache, and diarrhea, among others. After all this, more fluid enters the interstitium and then to alveoli, leading to interstitial and pulmonary edema, so preventing the exchange of gases. While hypoxemia and shortness of breath or dyspnea become noticeable symptoms, the inflammatory signals recruit more immune cells to the site of injury, like neutrophils and monocytes. Recruited neutrophils release reactive oxygen species and proteases to destroy the infected cells, and which also destroy the adjacent normal cells. Consequently, as the water dilutes the surfactants, the alveolus collapse and cause acute respiratory distress syndrome. It is noteworthy here that when the immune system attacks the infected cells, it also kills the healthy cells, which consequently results in three things that result in ADRS. First one is alveolar collapse because of loss of surfactants due to the destruction of type 2 alveolar cells. Secondly, less oxygen enters the bloodstream due to the lack of type 1 cells. And third, more fluid enters the alveoli, which may cause fibrosis. Some of the antigen-presenting cells after the engulfment of infected cells move to the lymph nodes to present the viral antigen to T cells. CD4 plus and CD8 plus T cells play a critical role as CD4 plus T cells activate B cells to promote the production of virus-specific antibodies, while cytotoxic or CD8 plus T cells kill viral infected cells but also contribute to lung injury. If the condition worsens further, the protein rich fluid enters the blood and reaches other areas of the body, causing systemic inflammatory response syndrome. SIRS may cause multi-organ failure and septic shock. Due to increased capillary permeability throughout the entire body circulatory system, which lead to edema and decreased blood volume and total peripheral resistance, resulting in hypotension and decreased blood perfusion to multiple different organs. This can lead to multiple system organ failure and septic shock. Consequences can be fatal, but with proper care, patient may recover at any stage during this process. COVID-19 has been considered as a type of self-limiting infectious disease. In most cases, with mild symptoms can recover in 1 to 2 weeks. Incubation periods mean the time between virus entry to the appearance of symptoms is approximately 5.2 days for this virus. This infection is more dangerous for high-risk patients, that is above 60, and those with cardiovascular diseases, autoimmune diseases, diabetes, chronic respiratory diseases like COPD, asthma, and cancer. Smoking and obesity are also susceptible factors. Lastly, COVID-19 patients can be classified into 5 categories based on symptoms and clinical condition. First one is asymptomatic patients with COVID-19 nucleic acid test positive without any clinical symptoms and signs, with chest imaging normal. Mild. Patients with symptoms of acute upper respiratory tract infection with fever, fatigue, myalgia, cough, sore throat, runny nose, sneezing, or digestive symptoms like nausea and vomiting, abdominal pain, and diarrhea. On third number, we have moderate. Patients with symptoms like pneumonia include frequent fever, cough with no evident hypoxemia, and chest CD with lesions. On fourth is severe. Patients with symptoms of pneumonia and hypoxemia. The last one is critical. Patients with acute respiratory distress syndrome may have shock, encephalopathy, myocardial injury, heart failure, coagulation dysfunction, and acute renal injury. And with this, thanks for watching our video and support us by subscribing our channel.